Hacker Hotel 2020. We're almost at the end. Some people decided to stay over till tomorrow, so that's really awesome. You all can stay after this talk and slowly empty your rooms. You have late checkout, so 7 o'clock. So until 7 o'clock, and you're still also allowed to stay in the restaurant. You can stay all night. We'll still be here, but we will be tearing down infrastructure. And then in the end, we will all meet up in the bar. So, and if you want to lend a hand, that's very cool. As you can see, you might recognize the the slide deck of last year. Some people asked for clothing. Tim from Get Merch had a lot of difficulties with all the different designs and stuff. So there will be a run, but it will probably be the original design. So if people are here for the first time and don't have this the original design, then the order the shop will open, and you can still order merch. Also, the mugs, they are stuck in China. When they arrive, they will be shipped out at no extra cost. And for the other orders, you need to add cost. I mean, that's you could have ordered them. I don't know. I didn't do anything. You could have ordered them when they were delivered here to the hotel. So if you didn't take that option, unfortunately, you have to add shipping cost. So you can do that in the orders when the shop opens again. And you can bundle Hackerspace orders. So if you bundle orders, I can maybe deliver them, or you can pick them up, or whatever. But bundling makes it easier for the guys of Get Merch. So that will be nice. So the fake Hacker Hotel merchandise shop will still be open very soon. Before I finish up Hacker Hotel, I want to point out some other events. ETH0 will be running again. Sebastian's date.
Somewhere near the Halloween weekend.
Somewhere near the Halloween weekend, there will be ETH0 in Lichtenvoorde. And that's in the east of the Netherlands. And you're all invited to go there. And there's lots of familiar faces. Of course, MCH will be next year. So please all go there if you like this and you're here for the first time. And if you're an seasoned veteran, then don't miss this, of course. There will be others. Myself, I will be visiting EMF Camp this July. I can really recommend it. It's a very friendly atmosphere. There's a lot of people having lots of great projects, friendship. It's really cool. And after that, 2 weeks later or 3 weeks later, there's also Born Hack in Denmark. And I will be bringing my flamethrowers there as well. So hopefully to see you all there. And then now, without sponsoring, an event like this wasn't possible. Stuff like chairs, all kinds of extra stuff. I printed some banners this year, and really, really very happy how they turned out. But without sponsoring, it wouldn't be possible to pay that all from the small add-on, which is in your tickets. So really, really thank you so much for all the sponsors. There were really a lot of sponsors. First off, our main sponsor, Guardian 360. Incredible guys and helped me immensely. So thank you and give it up for the main sponsor, Guardian 360. Platinum sponsor, Access42. These guys were amazing. Not only did they be the platinum sponsor, you saw maybe the nice placemats they made. You can bring them to home if you want to have some puzzling on the boat for the people from England. It's really cool, but next to their normal sponsoring, when we were in need, as Sebastian pointed out in the batch talk, and we needed more money to make it more awesome, of course, because else you would have had my ID with the heart shape with Hacker Hotel. Thanks to Nicolette, that didn't happen. So they jumped in and offered more money. So these guys were sponsoring and sponsoring again. So a big shout out to Access42. Thank you so much. Then the gold sponsors, and I'd like to stress that I forgot KPN Consulting last year. They are in here now. We double-checked, triple-checked, and quadruple-checked. And I'm so sorry for that last year. So starting from the top, Red Team Security, I already mentioned them. They had this awesome whiskey tasting. Some bottles were already emptied after 1.5 hours. Others took all night, which is very cool. If you missed it, be there next year. They really saw Hacker Hotel as a project within their company. So every 3 months they set a goal. And for now it was Hacker Hotel, and they brought it all together. They made the smoked salmon, they made the Soma FN banners, they made the whiskey. So that's really awesome. Schuberg Village, I don't know if you saw the racetrack upstairs. It's a AWS deep racing experience. So really awesome. KPN, people of KPN brought the television set up. As I understand, it wasn't working completely correctly, but it was it's very interesting, and Dustin can really talk with a lot of passion about being an amateur TV and radio ham amateur. So that was really awesome, and if you missed him, it's still probably you can meet him up in the hacking area. Please talk to him, he's a very knowledgeable guy. And they made all this stuff, they brought it all in to Hacker Hotel for your enjoyment. So thank you for Red Team Security, Schuberg Villis and KPN Consulting. Silver sponsors, Shakura, I pointed it out with an extra tweet this morning. They brought the industrial control system set up, which you were allowed to hack. You can sniff the traffic, very cool. Sophos, of course, we had a talk yesterday of the Sophos telling about malware. Tesorium was here about the malware talk. It was really nice presentation by Gijs and Saskia. Cybersprint brought you the cans of Coke Zero. If you dislike Coke Zero, you can drop them at me because I drink them at work. So, and it's really cool. And they had a nice beer mats as well to go. So you check them and you saw them in your room. And at the last minute, last month, we had the Fristy Leaks meeting, or 2 months ago already. And I spoke to Dave Marsland from EZ. And he said, well, sounds interesting. He never heard of Hacker Hotel before, so I explained him. And within no time, he decided to sponsor us too. So thanks for Secura, Sophos, Cybersprint, Tesorion, and EZ. And then we had a lot of bronze sponsors as well. Freedom Internet, Jonker, and Procolix. They joined in just seriously last week. So I'm really happy to be able to add them. For the people that listened to Anko's talk yesterday, it was very cool, and I hope you'll all be members there and move your stuff over for the business people when they come available to Freedom Internet. This way, they sponsored money, and they also sponsored the speakers' dinner, which I'm very grateful for. Zerocopter, well, they sponsored, and they sponsored the bar, so it's double sponsoring again. So thanks, big shout out to Chantal and Edwin for that. Jonker, Elger, thank you so much for sponsoring at the last minute. And also Misha Peters, OpenBSD, thank you very much for the people that saw this talk this morning. Very interesting, it's been recorded so you can look it back. So please give it up for our bronze sponsors. Bad sponsors, I'd like to add AllNet China in this. Our friend Norbert, who takes care of all the parts, and they're all that go on the badge, and he's a good man, and he helps us, and he makes great deals in China, and we love to work with him. And next to that, Stegen, the offer for the pick and place machine when we were really down the shit, and it wasn't needed. Just a few hours later, that was cool, but the offer standard was there, so it was really awesome. Aurelio, Jan Los, thanks also for the nice compliments for the event. And there they are again, Access42, as I pointed out earlier. And Magion, which not only sponsored the badge, they also sponsored, as Sebastian already pointed out, for the ones that missed it, they sponsored all the food and drinks for the people that were there doing the rework to make these awesome badges for you all. So I'm really grateful for the badge sponsors, but also for badge teams. So please give it up for the badge sponsors. You wouldn't be hearing us, and you wouldn't be seeing me, if there were no lights, if there were no beamers, no screens and stuff, if it wasn't for Stephen from Foxit. So I'm very grateful for Stephen of Foxit to sponsor us again, and also for Dennis helping set it up and controlling it, because he's the one that's in the back always doing the sound. So give it up for Stephen and Dennis Foxit. So So I'm still looking if the staff of the hotel have arrived already. Yes, please come forward. Because not in my slide deck, because I promised, of course, as I always do, Michael, to send stuff for in my presentation, and then I forget and I'm busy. So, but I really, really like to thank out and stress that working with these wonderful people from the hotel, Rick from the Department of Drinks and Food, Beverage, Food and Beverages, sorry, and also Evelyn, I called her like, I think, I will look it up in the phone, you'll get the stats, but if it's like 200 plus calls, I'm not exaggerating, for the last week. So please, give it up for Evelyn and Rick. Thank you so much, and I hope to be working with you again next year. And thank you so much, and also for your staff, because they were very friendly and they helped us tremendously. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Give it up for the hotel staff. There's some network stats. It's always nice to have Grafana stats. I hope it's Grafana, not that. Thank you. And the stats, you can see we burned a lot of traffic, like 1.7 terabytes of traffic. It's a 200 megabit line. So squeezing that amount of data through it can only be possible with guys and girls and from Event Infra. So please give it up for Event Infra. Arjan, Samantha, Roy, all the other people that helped out, Reiner, all the people that helped set up the networks, even in the hotel rooms you have Wi-Fi. It's amazing. And what's good to know is that we met with the people that do the normal IT infrastructure, so not when we are here with all the extra stuff, but the normal IT. These guys were really impressed by what you all brought and what they learned and the quality of the talks, they were really amazed. And we also set up a small meeting with them, where we talked what could improve for us, because the Event Infra guys have to basically tear the whole hotel infrastructure apart, but we also do it while the hotel is in service, cash registers, the booking system. So we talk to them and see if we can improve this coming year. So maybe next time it will be just as simple as plugging in some switches. That will be tremendous. So it was really cool to talk to these guys, and the meeting was set up with the hotel. They arranged that for us. So again, a big shout out to the hotel and Event Infra. I was wondering if I could see on the stats how many iOS and Android devices there were. I can't read it. There's something there. 45 iPhones. Yes, because I was contemplating maybe making a nice app for iOS and Android. So next year you might be able to get push notifications when you are about to miss a talk, that it reminds you to go there. So something I was just thinking of, and I needed to know the stats, but if there's 113 people and 45, so that would be nice to have push notifications, and then maybe we can have a streamlined schedule and all connected up to the screens and on your phone and on the website, so it's people know how to do that or know how pre-talks works, because we might be using pre-talks, then please contact me. So, now, finally, shout out to all sponsors again. Yeah, I can't really stress this enough. Thank you so much. Thank you for not stickering the hotel. For the people that saw my opening talk, please, thank you. Thank you. Thank you to the badge and the coin team, as you heard in the talks. Crazy stuff, Sake, the other guys. Thank you so much for offering your night sleep to... Yeah, that's a good one. Thank you for the addition. Thank you so much, Anne-Jan. Some people, and I'm also included, and as Sebastian said, they said, we won't tell you because you tell people and you talk too much, so we won't tell you the secrets, but you can pay for it. And I can only pay for it because of a sponsor money. So we set up a day, and I will put it out on our Twitter account, but we will make a afternoon in BitLair, where we bring all these special paintings you need and all the special stuff you need to solve the batches. So we'll turn basically BitLair into the escape room. And the coin challenges, they will be all be in BitLair. So we can meet up, have like an after party in a few weeks from now. I need to set a date, but we'll be okay. We'll communicate that, and then everybody can come in. We'll have a small party, maybe we order pizzas or whatever, and then we can do the batch coin again. And if you already solved it, then we might be able to reset your batches, and you can just play again and help other people along the way. And so you can relive the best experience. Thanks, Anjan, for the heads up. That was really cool. We will need a temporary batch team. I already spoke with one person of the current batch team, so we'll have to see how that goes. Sorry? That's a backup plan. So we can always make something, but if people stand up and say, I'd like to have a go, and we have sponsoring, because that's also an important thing, then please stand up and let me know as well. The feedback form will be up Tuesday. So you can let me know in the feedback form if you can help in any way or shape or form. Also, it's not in the talk yet because I didn't submit it. Some people helped me out tremendously, as I mentioned earlier, Mendel, the guys from Event Infra, the people that were here on Thursday night building up, but also the people like Chantal, Rowan, the people that manned the check-in desk. I really need more people to help me out. But this year I could finally say, it was a we event. I didn't do this alone. I didn't do this the last 5 years alone. But this year, so many people stepped up their game that it was really, really awesome. So I would really like to thank those volunteers that stepped up and helped me out. So thank you so much. Again, as I told, I didn't see the presentation before, so I'm just improvising. So. But also next to the network, we had a lot of power people. The guys from England drew all the heavy 380 three-phase cables down the window, all into the technical areas and rooms connected. Those cables are not really light. So if the people are here and want to help out rolling up these cables tonight, you're so much welcome to help out. But these guys did a great job as well, and we didn't have any power outage whatsoever. And then Anneliese, I want to thank her as well. For sticking up with me last year, listening, rambling me on, and not hearing her, but only sending about a hacker hotel, but I would like to have said it. And then you guys, without you, it wouldn't be possible. So many cool ideas. The guys from the Operaptor team that brought the shitty add-on fix, basically. That was cool. All kinds of people that jumped in the last minute, brought like the big spiral from TD Venlo. I can keep going on. Jenny for writing a great articles, Michael for help with the presentation. I can keep on, but each and every one of you, really, really thank you for your talks, your workshops, your patience with me if I didn't answer fast enough. So thank you so much for being here. I hope I see you all next year, and I'd like to end up that you were being excellent, and I saw a very nice tagline on Jan Martijn's WhatsApp, and it says, if you're living the dream, you don't have to sleep. And that was basically true for this weekend. But yeah, this is my dream. So thank you so much. And then now, to not really end it, but end this and the talks part, I will close down the space state. I love this gift from TD Venlo. Again, thank you so much. If you want to help out, you're more than welcome. We start teardown straight after the talk. You can be in the bar area. You can be here all night. It's no problem. You can have food in the bar. You can order stuff before you drive. Be careful. It's really, really windy outside. Storm's coming. So be careful when you go home. Stay safe. And then use the feedback form. I'll try to get it up on Tuesday. So here we go. Thank you again.